Good morning. Does God require his people to live differently? We're looking at Jeremiah chapter 7 today, verses 1 to 7. The word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord, saying, "Stand in the gate of the Lord's house and proclaim there this word and say, hear the word of the Lord, all you of Judah who enter in at these gates to worship the Lord. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, amend your ways and your doings, and I will cause you to dwell in this place. Do not trust in these lying words, saying, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord, the temple of the Lord are these. For if you thoroughly amend your ways and your doings, if you thoroughly execute judgment between a man and his neighbor, if you do not oppress the stranger, the fatherless, and the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, or walk after other gods to your hurt, then I will cause you to dwell in this place, in the land that I gave to your fathers, forever and ever." So there's some conditions going on here. If then, God sends his prophet Jeremiah not just to stand at the gates of the city this time, but to stand at the gate of the temple. I mean, he's gone all the way into the temple. And the very warning that he's going to utter has to do with this temple. Now, if the previous warnings didn't really make anybody nervous, maybe this one will, because this is the temple. In chapter 17, you'll remember, Jeremiah warns about the city being burned because of disregard for God's seventh-day Sabbath. And here, in this chapter 7, which we've shifted to now, because we believe this probably follows chapter 17 roughly in point of time, now the temple itself is the focus. Jeremiah warns them, do not trust in the temple, because you have this idea that, well, this city houses the temple, so at least nothing bad's going to happen here. He says, do not take that for granted. Isn't it true? Doesn't the Bible say that obedience is more important to God than sacrifice? Yes, it does. And rebellion is like the sin of witchcraft? Yes, it does. God's not going to let them lean on the Ark of the Covenant being present there. Remember what happened when they took the Ark into battle against the Philistines back there in Samuel? Yes, you do. God wants a personal relationship with them. He wants a connection of love and trust. He wants to gift his people with blessings, but they're blessings that they can only handle if they're responsible servants. And so often God would love to bless us. He would love to bless his church today, but he looks at us and he says, these are not responsible servants. I can't give them this gift. It's like, you know, giving your kids power tools. You've got a kid that wants to play with the power tool, but sometimes the kids aren't ready for power tools yet. Yeah, they could sever a limb or a finger or something. So you just have to say, no, it can't be yet. A lot of times the church isn't ready yet. God is ready, but the church isn't ready. You see, what you believe you are is reflected in what you do. So Jeremiah talks exactly like Jesus is going to talk centuries later. He tells them, you know, be honest, don't hurt people, all these kinds of things. This is just like Jesus talking. When you read Jeremiah and see what he's saying here, it's just like Jesus. Help the fatherless and the widow. Living God's way means that something is manifest in the life. Something actually pops out into the world. It's not just theory. It's not just theoretical, but it's a change in how you actually live. Now, a question, will God be firmer with them than he will be with us? I mean, we're over 2,000 years later. We've got so much that, you know, we're after the cross. We're responsible for knowing so much more. Is he going to be lighter with us than he was with them? Don't count on it. To whom much has been given, much is required. And you know, Jeremiah is not just talking to them, he's talking to us. 1 Corinthians 10, verses 6 and 11. Now all things happen to them as examples, and they became our examples on whom the ends of the ages have come. They're written for our admonition, so let's be admonished. Let's pray. Dear Father in heaven, help us to learn from the lesson, the warning that Jeremiah has for the people as he stands at the temple gate. Bless us. Build us, recreate us, help us to be right on, tracking with your commandments, loving to do what you want us to do, trusting you, living your way. Help us, Lord, in all those things. Please help your church today, Lord. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. So yes, it's our privilege to live differently every day and to breathe in the power of God's helps. May you have a wonderful day. Serving the Lord Jesus Christ.